All right, we're going to talk about evaluating expressions today, okay? So we've got some tennis balls up here, and what I'd like to do first is go through and describe the tennis balls. So talk to me about this tennis ball. What's special about it? Yeah?
It's blue and like dark green.
I'm going with this is blue, so what are we going to call that?
Dark green.
I'm going to shorten it to make
green.
Yeah, I like that. So I've got green, and it's math class. I'm not looking to write a whole lot. What am I going to call green in terms of a variable? Yeah.
G.
Sounds good to me. Do we have some other stuff we want to label?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Red.
How many? Bunch, right?
Sure.
But each one of these, red, that's the color. What's the variable going to be?
R.
I like it. That's going to make writing a lot easier. Anything else in here that's different? Yeah.
Blue.
Mm-hmm. What are we calling that?
Bean.
Great. Okay, does everybody have a color and a variable? And
yeah.
We're all using the same variables? All right, so our next thing to do is we're going to write an expression. We're going to put all this stuff together. Maybe this is what we need. If we're going to do a dog training class, these are the tennis balls that we need to have. I don't know, right? I know my dog would love to play with those tennis balls. So, what are we going to start out? What do we call this guy?
Green.
Okay.
G.
Okay, G. Everybody writing a G?
Yeah.
How do we talk about this stuff? Yeah.
2R.
I need a verb. I like your 2R. What?
A plus.
Okay. So we got this, we got this. How about this? Who's got this piece?
Plus B.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Plus one.
And last one?
Plus G.
How come we didn't just call this two something? Yeah.
They're not the same color.
Yeah, they're not like terms. We can't combine them yet. Okay. Everybody have that? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. What are we going to start talking about here? Yeah.
The green balls.
Okay. So this, underline your G, and let's copy it here. We're going to start with that green ball. What would we like to put with that green ball? Yeah.
The other green ball?
Hmm. So what are we going to do here?
We're going to, bring it over.
What did I do first?
Oh, yeah, underline.
Just the G or the plus G?
The plus G.
Yeah, so you're going to do this. Agreed?
Yeah.
Now I want to see what you wrote. We got a G, and I want you to be able to get... You're going to move that here, right? Yeah. Yeah. Looks good. Okay, don't go on. I want to see what you're doing with us. Yes. All right, so we've got that. All right, the next thing we're going to do is this term. So we're going to underline plus 2R and copy it. Oops, I didn't get the plus G. Plus 2R, what's going to go along with these two reds?
What?
We got these two R's.
Yeah.
What are we going to put with it?
The other R.
Right? Okay, show me what I did here on the board. Show me with these symbols. So you got to take this, put it here. All right, there's one more piece after this. Yeah, Rose?
Plus B.
Yeah, it's already in the right spot, but we have to make sure we get this here. How many terms are in this top? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many better be here?
5.
Okay, you check and make sure you got 5 terms. Again, terms are separated by plus signs, minus signs, equal signs. We all good? All right, what's the next thing we can do?
Combine our terms.
We're going to combine. So it says G plus G.
2G.
Nice. Underline this, we're going to put that together. two g's plus, all right, how are we going to talk about this? 2r plus r. Can we put it together? Everybody?
3r.
Okay, so all that stuff turned into 3r.
Yeah.
How come we didn't say 4 something? Because they're not like terms. Okay, what do we still have to deal with here? So what do I do here?
Plus b.
Nice. That looks a lot simpler than that. Can we combine anything else?
No.
Can't combine them. Okay, so now what we're going to have to do is figure out some values. So these blues, all right, sorry, these greens, I'm going to tell you that greens are the least valuable today. They're only worth $2 a piece. So I'm going to put a 2 here. The red balls, my dog Alfie loves the red balls because he can see them better. They're worth $5 each. And since there's only one blue, that's the most valuable of all. 10. So the next thing we're going to do is substitute, yes? So I'm going to start here. It says 2 times g, or g 2 times. I'm going to put a 2, and then parentheses. Now, what's a g worth?
2.
It's worth $2 today, so I'm going to put that inside the parentheses. So that means 2, 2 times, plus 3, plus... I'm going to let you figure this out. Okay, so this one, this was 3 times the value of a red. What's a red worth today?
10. Oh, right.
What is it worth?
10. 5.
5. So instead of saying 3 times r, you're going to say 3 times
5.
5. Yeah. Okay, and this was a blue.
10.
Okay, so that should be 10, yes?
Yes.
All right, you guys help me.
So should we do 5 times 3? Or should we do 5 times 1 and 3 times?
That's an excellent question. Let's make sure we have this plugged in right. What did you guys plug in instead of r when you substituted? What's an r worth today?
5.
5.
Everybody get a 5 there?
Yeah.
Okay, what did you put here instead of a b?
10.
Oh, good. All right, so this says 2 times. What's that worth?
4.
Right underneath all this stuff, 4. What's the verb?
Plus.
What's the value of all these red balls?
15.
How'd you get that? You're right.
3 times 5.
Yeah, it's 5 3 times. $15. Okay, and the value of the one blue ball?
10.
Is 10. All right, one last step. We need to add all this together, yes?
Uh-huh.
I might choose to do this first, because it's 25, and then 4 more. Get you...
29.
I'm getting 29. Nice. Cool. Thanks very much.